So this isn't technically a burger. It's more so just ground beef. But I'm gonna cook the whole thing like it's a burger. So enjoy. And so a really interesting thing that I learned is that apparently paprika goes really good on a lot of stuff, which is something that you probably never would have ever guessed, but it is the truth. And the only reason why I'm using paprika is because I don't have any pepper right now, but yes, just paprika from Walmart, along with salt. The only issue that paprika has is that it burns, or not burns, but it chars really easily. So I'm definitely gonna need this. I know that paprika goes well on a burger like this because I did try it the other night, and while I set off my smoke alarm like 6 or 7 times, those are really good burgers that I made. Like damn, they're good. And I'm gonna need this thing's really big and thick, so it's gonna take a while to cook, which means I'm definitely gonna need. Need a lot of heat, and I'm gonna need a lot of time. And I guess if you wanted to, you could think about this as if it were me teaching you how to cook a burger. But you also don't have to think about it that way. That's not what my intention was for this video. I was just about to eat this, and then I realized that it might be fun for you guys to watch me cook this monster-sized burger. Even though it's not really a burger and it's actually just ground beef or whatever. But this is, so, I mean, you saw the package. This is supposed to be 100% or organic grass-fed ground beef, which, so usually things that are organic or grass-fed or other stuff like that are usually said to taste better along with them just being generally healthier because they're more natural. Now it's seasoned. I need a lot of heat. I'm probably gonna need a lot of time, so this might be a pretty long video. I'm already at 8 minutes, basically. And preemptively, I'm just going to take the batteries out of my smoker. Okay, well. All right, that is taken care of. Whenever there's a fucking insane amount of smoke, least the smoke alarm. Now this thing is really soft, so I'm not entirely sure how I'm gonna get it into the pan without it falling apart on me. There we go. This thing's gonna be cooking for a long time, probably. And so all that you gotta do is sit back and relax. However long this is gonna take. And I can already tell you, even though I literally just put it into the pan, it already smells pretty good, actually. So I can't wait to try this thing. When I was making the burgers I made the other night, I was really afraid that they were going to be undercooked, because even though they were all really small, actually, came out pretty well, and they all tasted really great. It's kind of funny to think that paprika can get so black and it look like it's just straight up burned, but the flavor is still so strong in there. So I'm just gonna let this thing cook and you can enjoy the sizzling sounds until then. If you actually look in a little closer, you can actually start to see a lot of the fat is oozing out already. Can I even move it around? Or is it all stuck? There we go. This thing is nice and big, so it's probably gonna take a while for it to really get there. Thank you. can never have too much butter. Okay, I'm gonna try to flip this thing now. It shouldn't break while I try to flip it. I've already decided that I am indeed going to keep flipping it. Ooh, look at that. So that's not the actual meat burn. That's all the paprika. Just got a little bit of color on it. Thanks to the heat, a lot of the paprika is gonna just stick right onto the pan, which is, it's okay. I can easily clean the pan off, so. Now, I gotta get the important part. Putting butter on this side. Look how quickly the butter soaks into the burger. That's awesome. It's still really soft in the center. I don't want to be eating undercooked ground beef. Thanks to the way that beef's genetic makeup works, it's actually relatively safe to eat when it's undercooked, but obviously not desirable for plenty of reasons. Look at that, like all the butter has completely absorbed into the burger or has seeped through the cracks. How about for more? Maybe it's like paint. A certain amount of it will absorb,
flip it again. But this time I'm going to take a, more of a look at the sides. Still pretty soft. It's going to need a lot more work before it's ready. Still pretty soft, so fell over on me. What a jerk. It still feels pretty soft, but I can feel it firming up, so I think we're getting there. Definitely getting there. we're nearly there, so I'm going to turn off the heat now. Because this thing is really firming up now. Still very soft in the middle. You probably saw on the package, this is only an 85-15. Which means that it's not gonna, which means that it didn't, it only lost about 15% of its size at most, thanks to the fat seeping out of it, which that's where a lot of the flavor comes from, is the fat. It's kind of counterintuitive that the fat could seep out of the burger and yet be one of the biggest things that causes all the flavor to happen.
I'm gonna put the butter away. And boom.
Tongs are really hot. Everything is really hot. I'm gonna keep the fan on. We're gonna cut into this thing to see if I cooked it all the way. I'll use my special knife, of course. Special cuisine art knife. And my honing steel, where is this? Another thing, if you do really want to see a series where I show you how to cook certain things that I've gotten pretty good at cooking, just let me know down in the comments. But here's the moment of truth. That looks pretty good, I think. It could be, it's a little bit more pink than I'd like, but at the very least, I'd say it's done, but I might give it another go off camera. But there it is. Let me know what you guys think about this down in the comments. Thank you very much.